नमस्ते एवरीवन, एज यू नो वी ऑल आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन रिफ्रेशर वन पार्ट वन वर्कशॉप व्हिच इज प्रेफरेबली डिजाइंड विद द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ कंडक्टिंग स्टूडेंट इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम इन आर ओन इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड विद दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव वी आर एक्सप्लोरिंग द टॉपिक्स पर्टिकुलरली फ्रॉम द स्टूडेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू विद देयर ओन माइंडसेट. So, and it's apparent in our own experience, in our past experiences, that videos and activities make the sessions more interactive or more interesting comparatively. So, we are going to include here in this refresher workshop also few video sessions as well as activity sessions, so that we may be prepared for student induction program. So today we are going to operate one of that video-based activity session. In yesterday's assignment, one video was mentioned and you were expected to or you were requested to watch that, based on which today's discussion will be. And I hope all of us are prepared after watching that video to discuss the things. So let me ask everyone available here whether we watched that or not. We are prepared for today's discussion session or still there is some gap. So please, you may respond in chat box. Have you watched it? जी अपराजिता मैम, नाउ वी कैन स्टार्ट.
यस दीदी, यस दीदी, वी हैव अ नंबर ऑफ हैंड रेज, सो आई जस्ट पास ऑन द माइक टू यू. चेतना जी, आई हैव चेतन जी, आई हैव पास ऑन द माइक टू यू एज वेल एज विकास जी, प्रभाकरन जी, आई हैव पास ऑन द माइक टू यू एज वेल. यू वुड लाइक टू इंटरैक्ट?
Hello.
Yes,
yeah. Welcome. Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, sir. Welcome.
Yeah. Yesterday I watched, but I could not understand. I mean, I can make out because of the language, you know, it was in Hindi, but by the accents and the other movements, I could understand the theme. So I responded in the assignment also. Now also I can talk on that.
Sir, subtitles are given there in English also. I hope you noticed. And only Hindi language is not there. Variety of regional languages are involved there purposely.
Oh, I missed it. Okay. Anyway, okay. No problem. See, as far as the part one is concerned,
okay.
Son, he has not accepting his mother's food and other thing. And he has walked off because of a call company requirement, and she got wild, and in turn she has shown it to the maid, working maid, and she in turn gone back to her house and shown it to her daughter, and daughter to her husband auto wala, then to a small boy and tender coconut seller, then again, the other customer of the tender coconut. Then he has gone to his boss, and it has shown finally an accident occurred. So around 7-8 people, so it has been transferred. The thing is, we are not able to see anybody is absorbing that emotional feeling. At least if anyone would have been observed, had it been observed, then the chain would have been broken. So it's a lesson to everyone that we should not be via media for the emotional occurrences, and we should try to evaluate ourselves, and we should not pass it on to the others. That is from the part one. And from the part two, the same theme we are able to, same lesson we are able to learn, but the situation is different. Everyone becomes very happy. Everyone was very highly happy, extreme happy. So that also finally leads to the accident, severe accident. So here also, even if it is a happy mood, that also should not go beyond the extreme. We should be happy, correct, no doubt. But we should not go beyond the limitation, and it should not be passed on to the next person. To some extent, it should be curtailed. That's what we are able to learn from this. And in both the parts, the chain is continuous. It has finally made a roundabout and came to the same person, the effect, the final effect. Sometimes it may come to ourselves, or it one way or another, somebody else will be the finally victimized. Will be affected. So as a human being, we should try to use our sixth sense and use our self-evaluation. We should validate ourselves and try to console ourselves, and we should not try to pass it on to them. That's what we could learn from the video.
Very nice, sir. So sir is sharing about the video which we are expecting from all of you to watch and, you know, to discuss thereafter in today's session. And that was titled as Right Here, Right Now. And this is a short documentary which is dealing about human behavior and its propagation, as sir is, sir is expressing. And sir noticed preferably the reaction, the chain, which is going on, which is continuing, as well as after, sir is referring that in one incident of happiness, that chain of happiness sequence that is also continuing. So sir's observation that is regarding that. But in total, it is for sure that we are observing variety of interactions here in this short video or documentary. So we have to discuss while watching as well as while evaluating or analyzing these interactions. Were these reactions or responses in various interactions? So let us recollect various scenarios, various scenes, and what we are instead of evaluating after watching that. So let us see a few more observations regarding that particular video right here, right now. Let us get some more responses from your side.
Thank you, sir. We have Chetanji, Devi Charanji. Devi Charanji, I have passed on the mic to you.
Yeah.
Yes, namaste, sir.
Good evening, all.
Good evening, sir.
Okay, ma'am, before that, actually, I had a doubt if I was supposed to be in this group or is there any other group?
There is no group variation for this session, sir. It will be for next session.
Next
session, there will be two groups. This is common session for all, sir. So you are welcome here.
Okay, ma'am, thank you. Yeah, thank you. And regarding the yesterday's video, so I saw that. And that's what I again observed is that because of one person's mistake, that negative thing what he initiates, so that is like propagated in the whole society. So that indicates that we have a responsibility of having the right emotions and right activities we are supposed to do, so that we really don't create harm in the society. Okay, and we should get more conscious so that we can observe such things, and we could avoid such fatal things happening to anybody who come across that chain. So that's the thing what I understood.
Nice. So I just wish to remind all of us that we are getting the session from the student point of view, what questions may be asked by students. So okay. let us explore the things, you know, according to them. Hmm? So let us see what questions may come from their side. And for that, particularly, we are required to analyze each and every scenes, you know, because it is expected from students that they will mention few of the scenes that it was there, you know. So let us practice. For example, as here I am showing one of the scenario or one of the scene from that video only. So here one of the statement that is as dialogue it is written here. So we can recollect our memory or our observations of that particular video in this way also, in this manner. So let me call a few other to share.
Yes, Kapse Mahadrudra ji, I have provided the mic to you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. In short, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. Yes. In a brief, the first part and the second part, as I said, or other people also said that, the first part, which initiate with or start or begin with itself with the negativity, and the chain of the negative happenings or the incidents takes place one after the another, and the ends with that an accident. Whereas the second part, the beginning itself is a very positive, and that positivity is throughout the second part, and it comes back to where the first part ends, that accident took place. So in a brief, I just want to say over here that the end of the part two is telling us about more about the positivity wins over the negativity, and finally that the person got injured in the accident is taken to the hospital. So okay. here I feel that here is a victory, or we can say this, it's a win over the negativity of the positivity.
Okay, so just this is nice exploration expressed by sir or shared by sir, but I just request all of you, you know, to don't be means judgmental, or just, you know, don't come up with some conclusions or morals, you know. And let us try to explore so that we can help others also, you know, in exploration. So we observe that there is a chain of positivity as well as negativity, you know, and after at the end of the video I'm concluding like, you know, that positivity wins over negativity. So these are certain statements, certain morals, you know. I just wish to get your exploration. Since morning, we are exploring variety of values, you know, variety of feelings, particularly trust. Then after respect in relation to relationship, you know, in connection to relationship. So whether we are able to see something in connection here in video, in this documentary, please share that if it is possible, if something is apparent after seeing this, after watching this. Yes,
Vikas Rawatji.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Whatever I want to say, most of you already mentioned. But here I want to mention this video is giving a message that if the negativity is spreading, this negativity would have not been spread if someone has acted maturely or positively. That is the things we have learned from this video.
Okay, let me help you all. You know, whether something related to our basic aspiration or universal aspiration that is reflecting here in this video, whether something we can relate with harmony or happiness that is here in the video, we can observe, we can share that.
Yeah, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, that each and everyone, suppose this scene here, the boy was trying to be friendly with that girl. Okay, so his intention was good. So, but the girl was not able to identify his intention. Okay, so those things, that basic intention was good, for even for the girl also would have been the same, but she was in that mood at that time. She was not in that compete level, and she has not acted like that.
What is the reason behind Nana lack of her competence? Are we able to evaluate that? So where's the issue? What is the problem actually? Can we explore?
Yeah, see, actually the girl was not able to identify why her mother is behaving like that, what might have gone wrong with her mother. She was not able to identify those things. That was the mistake in her part in this picture.
Okay, so that means the imagination or thought process of the that girl that is being affected or that is under influence of her mother right now when she's interacting with the boy, isn't it?
Yes.
And that's why she's not able to take decision at her own, although she is willing to connect with the boy. She is naturally desiring to have a relationship with the boy, to come up with a feel of relationship. But somehow, under influence of that effect, mother's effect or mother's interaction with her, previous interaction, she is not able to take right decision right now. And this what you are willing to express, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so one important conclusion we are getting that this is the decision which is not through her own, this is
influence.
Decision taken by someone on the basis of somebody else, as sir is saying. Okay, good. So let us explore more. Let us see few more observations, and let us give a chance to others to share their opinion about video.
Yes, Sidhi, we have Gurleen Sidhuji.
Thank you, Prajita ma'am. So here I would like to share that in both the videos, basically, the rather than responding, they were reacting. So in the negative, maybe it was like, you were doubting the other person's intention rather than focusing on their competence. And you were letting somebody, disturb your harmony, you're letting others affect your state. And even in the happy state, or like, we say the positive side, that positivity wasn't really based on your natural acceptance. It was what I could gather. It was more, based on sensations, like you're getting something and you get happy and excited about it. So I would state that was also excitement rather than happiness. And definitely if we respond rather than react, so none of these reactions would take place. And we wouldn't be affected by the other person's behavior if, we have that state of harmony within us. And eventually the end where, the girl is supposedly in love, where we say that love is, that complete value of the nine feelings. But the first feeling was missing, the trust wasn't there. So that was what I could see in this video. Thank you. Very nice exploration, ma'am.
You expressed your sharing particularly in terms of that you are able to distinguish between the state of excitement where the person is not able to respond, but she or he is in reaction, expressing himself or herself in reaction. And you are able to see that happiness or harmony is something else, which is outcome of right understanding. And whatever feelings they are expressing, that is not either means in positive state even, that seems not outcome of understanding, but it may be because of sensation, because of some external influences that you are expressing. Nice exploration.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Didi. We have Pratibha Patel ji.
Namaste, everyone. Namaste. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes. Madam, I have the same explanations as Gurleen Madam had told. It's about the inner harmony which gets disturbed in both the cases. On a positive end, in the second case, to an extent. But in the initially, we can see it very clearly, like the mother gets disturbed that she's putting in a lot of efforts and the son just doesn't react in any good way. So she takes up her frustration there and puts it over to her maid and removes her out of job. And then the maid goes back home and she takes her anger on the child, who is just getting ready to go to school, and says no more education for you, because that burden, if it is lesser on me, I can go to lesser houses, I wouldn't have to listen so much from so many people. So people were reacting, and their harmony within was getting disturbed by another individual's reactions to them, or probably their actions on them. So this was very clearly visible, and this chain could have been broken by any one of them in between, but they failed to do it. That is another observation, because the maid walked a long way back home. Probably if in between she could have just tried to calm herself down, maybe she wouldn't have reacted that way to her daughter. So those kind of thoughts also came into my mind when I was watching the video. These were a few observations, and as Madam also told, it's very, very visible from the video that any good or bad, not good or bad actually, any disturbed action from our end definitely will come back to us in one or the other way. So ensuring harmony within oneself can actually ensure the harmony in the society at large. So that is also another observation in this particular video, ma'am.
Nice expression. Thank you, ma'am, for sharing. And you included here particularly that this chain may be broken by everyone, by any one of these, although no one had tried for the same, but there is possibility. So yes. when this possibility that will take place, let us explore about how this chain that is persisting or that is taking place one after another. And what is the gap actually, and how this can be broken? Let us explore a little more about this. What may be the reason behind the gap, as well as to reach towards solution? Let us see a few more observations. Let us listen to a few more sharings from your side.
Yes, Siddhi, we have Chandrasekhar ji with us.
Yes, madam. Thank you for the opportunity. Madam, I believe that any action or reaction or response will have its ripple effect. That is, one giving the effect of the other, and it passes on continuously. So if you do the positive acts or the positive thoughts, it will definitely lead to the positive vibration, and in turn it will spread positiveness in the environment. Similarly, if you show some adverse situation, it will reflect in continuously in the all linked activities. In a day-to-day life, all those we cannot live in isolation, and it is not a closed system. We are always open for the interaction, and we come across so many environmental interventions. So in this case, suppose the relationship is there, the first thing is that we are in the very first instant itself, the relation is not taken into with a good intention, that I doubt the other person's intention, that what he or she is doing or what she or he is not doing. The moment I start doubting and I do not put myself in the other shoes, then when there is no way of thinking in an empathetic way, then what happens is a series of questions creeps into my mind, and automatically I lose my harmony. When there is a disharmony, naturally I want to have a tendency to come back to the harmony. Let us say, for example, in the earlier video, it is shown that the maid, what she did when the housewife, she banged at her, she in turn, she went into disharmony. Her disharmony converted into her disharmony. And in order to get rid of her, she threw away the vessels. And again, because she assumed that if she throws the vessels out, then she'll be back to the harmony. But actually, it is not the case. So what I analyze and what I see from all these cases is that if we are in a harmony, we can promote harmony in the environment or the activities, whichever comes next to us. But if we are in a disharmony and we fail to bring back to harmony in a positive sense, naturally, it will also get transformed. And in the process, everything goes into chaos and confusion. And if you come back and analyze, 99% we are the root cause for that. So it is not the way we react or the way we act. It is the way we respond to the situation that is more important. And that's what I would like to add that. And when there is a mutual trust amongst us, these things can easily be convinced and can easily be discussed, can easily be open-minded. With open-minded, we can sort it out so that there will be a harmony in the environment wherever we go and wherever we are in. So this is what I would like to share through this platform. So thank you, madam, for the opportunity.
Very nice. So we are getting that harmony is desirable as we are connected to each other. And that's why harmony in our own thoughts as well as disharmony in our thoughts, that is, you know, reflecting each one of us. You know, that is reflecting outside and that is affecting each one of us. That's why this matters for us to understand harmony, what actually it is. You know, and how we can proceed or how we can make program to ensure this. So this is very good sharing from Sir's side, that harmony within that reflects outside and that reaches to everyone. That's nice, but what actually this harmony is, Anna, is it actually means understanding what we desire, what is naturally acceptable to us, as well as to work on that, or is doing anything, whatever the others are doing. So what actually it is? Let us explore a few more points in relation to
this. Yes, we have Anjali Pavagiji.
Thank you so much. Apart from the observations that others have mentioned, definitely positive, negative chain reactions and karma and as I mentioned in my assignment also, the smile that you send out returns to you. There are a few more one more observation was about respect and disrespect. So the lady felt neglected and her ego was hurt because her son refused to eat food. And the same she carried to her maid, and then further got the negative chain reaction of all the negativity. And as far as the previous slide was shown, the boy actually tries to neutralize thing, but after one or two attempts, her reaction is the same. And so then he carries the same negativity further. So that was one point where it was possible here, and he has tried his best, but couldn't hold on for long. One more thing that I have observed in the second part, at the end, when the doctor takes the patient, and there is a very small clipping of a girl who is again to be shown as irritated. Now it's up to her to doubt the intention or not to doubt the intention, because she's unaware of the situation that the boy is in. It was absolutely at the last, I think probably just before the the last slides of the name of the actors, so that she's waiting for the boy to come to get married, and then her reaction was little negative. So that was one observation where now it's up to her to doubt the intention of the boy or not to doubt. So that was my observation. And yes, there is a disrespect. There is no harmony in self. And that's what my observations are. Thank you so much.
Very nice, ma'am. That means feeling which we naturally desire, which is expected to all of us. And if we are expecting it from others, then very often we are in these types of situations. We are facing these types of situations. And sometimes other is able to fulfill it. Sometimes others are not able to fulfill it. So what is solution? What may be the way out for me? Is it always possible to get these feelings from others as I wish, naturally, forever, in continuity? Or there is any possibility to ensure it within? Is there something absolute, or is there something in form of right understanding which can help us in ensuring these feelings which we are naming as trust as well as respect within? So this we are trying to explore with the help of this documentary. Let me remind everyone that observing or watching this documentary merely doesn't with the idea of getting some type of influence from this documentary. We are just taking some incidences of our lives in which we are trying to validate the proposal. So the proposals in form of values, in form of feelings we received since morning, let us validate those proposals here in various incidences. And I'm happy to see that many of you are able to evaluate those proposals, to validate those proposals in various incidences. Nice. So let us proceed.
Yes, Didi, we have Abhijit with us.
Yes, ma'am. Namaste. Good afternoon. And,
sir, be a little bit louder.
Am I audible?
Little bit louder, sir. You are audible, but less
voice. Basically, I would like to talk about the first video which I have seen yesterday. And the reaction of the mother towards her son, because he was not following her, like she was insisting on to have a breakfast or lunch breakfast in the morning, but that the boy was not ready to accept it. But that particular thing, she lacked in understanding that she needs to. Needs to explain to her son that why is it important, instead of telling her son or having a dialogue with the son, she reacted to her maid, and which further that maid also reacted to that particular thing to her daughter. So it became a vicious circle. So basically, the change started at the reaction of the mother towards her son. So she has to build that patience, which we talked about in our slides, that there is a need to develop patience and develop competence to understand people. So understanding the things at individual level, at family level, is very important. And once we understand it properly, right understanding, then it will lead to right action, corrective action. But instead of corrective action, she exploded. So that led to so many issues further, which we have seen in the entire documentary. So the person who is reacting to a particular situation, right, instead of reacting because of the anger, one gets react. So one has to keep a patience. That is what in the relationship we have to understand, that how can we develop a patience, means at family level, at peer level, at superior level, at subordinate level. These are the issues in human life. So if we have to reach to that particular level, this kind of food for thought is necessary for every individual. So this kind of program like universal human values, if we could able to imbibe these values, So lot many issues which are there in the family and can be addressed. That is what I learned. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So program or action which is being expressed in various scenarios and various scenes that we are able to see, that is outcome of our own understanding. And even any action which is reflecting outside, before reflection, it is being planned inside, you know, within. So this is very important to see, is how much I am able to understand about relationship, then the feelings, you know, which are going to be expressed in relationship. So understanding about those feelings, that matters before making program to execute or to get the fulfillment in relationship. You know? So do be clear about these feelings, feeling of trust, feeling of respect, you know, and ensuring it within in every state or every situation. Or very often we are being influenced by others' action or by others' program in whatever state he or she is making her or his own program. Now, even I am, this is my own incompetence, that I am just being influenced by his or her behavior, what he or she is conducting, reflecting. I'm not able to see actually his or her natural acceptance, because this is my own incompetence to see the natural acceptance or to see the basic aspiration. So since date, no education helped me to explore my own basic aspiration, my own natural acceptance, although it is innate within, but somehow I'm not able to explore it. I'm not aware about this faculty which is within, that we are naming here as natural acceptance, as basic aspiration. And then we never try to explore for ourselves. Very often we are dependent for these feelings which are naturally desirable. We are dependent on others to get respect, to get trust in relationship. So this is a documentary which is helping us to explore that whether there is any possibility to ensure these feelings within, or there is always this is dependent on others, and not to ensure. So what is the state actually? If it is dependent on others' action, then obviously for continuity, it is not possible for us to ensure, because okay, this depends on others. So if I require it for us in continuity, say, for example, basic aspiration, happiness, if harmony, if I need it in continuity, I need to ensure it within. And for that, variety of feelings are being to explode within, being to establish within. And then we are seeing. So very often when we reflect anger, what does it mean? Which feeling actually I'm missing? So that we are going to explore here, seeing the anger which are being reflected here in this video. So what is the reason of that anger? Which feeling they are deprived of? That we are going to explore now for next 15 or so minutes.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your explanation.
Thank you.
Tejaswini ji.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon to all. Am I audible here?
Yes, ma'am. Clearly.
Thank you. As there is a video having two parts. First one shows the negativity circle is there, and second one is the positive vibes are there. So ultimately, according to my understanding, whatever I got the message, like whatever we do will come back to us in some way or some day. So we have to think before whatever we acting there, or before speaking there. So this is my point of view there.
Okay, so whatever we give, that will come to us. So what is there with us to give? Is it harmony? Is it respect? Is it trust? Are these values, are these feelings there with us? Are we able to see this within? Are we able to share this with others? or be dependent on others for these values, these feelings. What you say, ma'am?
Actually, this is within us, depends upon our natural active acceptance. It is not on any others, whatever the giving our appreciation and all. So I think it's all we can just choose on our point of view and at our own level.
Yeah, ma'am, you're not audible now. Didi, I think the ma'am has disconnected, I think so. Yes, ma'am, please.
Yes, ma'am. That depends upon our own natural acceptance. We have to just go with our whatever the trust, feeling, and love. These all kind of relationship qualities, and not to just whatever the influence or pre-sensations and conditionings are there. We don't have to just distract from our natural acceptance regarding that right understanding.
Thank you, Tejaswini ji. Renuka ji?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, welcome, ma'am.
Ma'am, like from yesterday's video, I can see that what goes around usually comes back or comes around. So I can see like different emotions or feeling like anger, love, happiness is a mixture of positive and negative, which passes on from say one person to another. So I feel like we are the weaver. For instance, if we weave anger, then anger will spread from one another. So it's our utmost duty, or I can say responsibility, to spread the positive vibes among us so that love and happiness will linger in our society. So like when I look into it, I find like the root cause for the chaos that is being spread throughout the movie or throughout the scene was like, it begins at the level of self. From the very beginning of the stories regarding the boy and the mother, like they lack right understanding and right feelings. Had the boy had the right feeling for him, for his mother, he could have just taken it. It doesn't take a minute, but he picked up the phone call and speak to his friend. Rather, he could have just accept what his mother was giving. Then again, so every level, I mean, all the most of the people in the scene, they lack right understanding and right feelings. So starting from the housewife, then the maid. So since there is disharmony in the self level, that disharmony spreads throughout the from individual to families, from families to society, it comes out from the family. So a chaos was there. But there I could find a boy who is not having much preconditioning, I should say. So he spread that happiness once again. And then because of that, that old lady, and then after that, her daughter also, who was upset for the first time, was happy, or I could say excitement. So what I want to say is, like the root cause, it's self. Because when we don't have the right understanding or right feeling for the others, or right feeling, then ultimately that disharmony within myself will leads to disharmony in my family, then it will even affect the society and possibly the whole level of order, because they are in the scene also, an accident occur out there. So all those, it's a chain. So starting from, so everyone needs to have that right understanding within self. So this is what I have to take away, ma'am.
Very nice. So nice exploration by you all. And it is expected by everyone's viewpoint that the reflection which is coming outside, either in form of happiness or in form of unhappiness, you know, that is being spreaded. That's true, and that we all observe. So external impacts, external consequences, external conduct or behavior, we are able to see. And this is very, means very obvious too. But my question is, are we able to see that these reactions or these anger, which are very much related to our daily routine, daily life, you know, are we able to see that actually this anger is matter of my own incompetence? And if so, means what is the reason behind this anger? In something which because of which, you know, we are showing this anger, are we able to extract that absence of something which is missing? So are we able to explore my own incompetence, which is reflecting in form of reaction or anger?
Yes, ma'am, I can say that like it's I lack the lack of feeling of complementary to one another. That is one thing. And then I feel like lack of competency, because there that will certainly lead to anger.
Very
so nice. Like I should feel that complementary to one another, that housewife also has to have that feeling of complementary with the housemate, though she is her subordinate.
Nice. So this complementarity is desirable in every relationship, either it is matter of son and mother, or it is matter of maid and his owner or his employer. So this complementarity is desirable, we are able to see. But why we are not able to ensure this complementarity? Or if we are able to ensure this, can we say that in each and every relationship, we are able to ensure this complementarity, or we are lacking somewhere? This is conditional for us. And in some relationships, we are complementary. In few others, we are not complementary. Mm. So what we say?
Because, ma'am, it's maybe because like we cannot rightly evaluate ourselves and others also. In one sense, I can say that we lack respect for others. Because if I rightly evaluate, then I think there won't be any problem between the housewife and the maid also.
So ma'am is able to see that there is something missing, and that something is right evaluation or respect, which we are referring here. Because we are not able to see that feeling within, feeling of right evaluation, feeling of respect. That's why this complementarity that is not being ensured. Let us see a few more responses, Abrajita ma'am, so that we can conclude.
Thank you, Renuka ji. We have Raghavendra ji next.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good afternoon, madam. Am I audible?
Yes, you are, sir.
From this video, I observed that I learned that there is independence in the society, ma'am. Among the people, there is independence. That's why I think we all have to work on the principle win-win. Otherwise, you be happy, I am happy, you are happy, like that. That is one point, ma'am, what I observe. The second thing is in the family, if let's say I have some conflict with my sister. So, in general, what happens is I may not communicate with her and solve the issue. Rather, I will show this angry on some other people, So, which does not solve the actual problem. So, if you understand what is the problem and with whom we have the problem, like we, as you said, right understanding. So with that, if I talk with that person only, but not with some third person like that, then I think the relations can be built in a better way, ma'am.
Okay, nice. So as your viewpoint means dialogue between two, that is at most desirable, right? So yes. That we can solve the issues. But what we will discuss, whether we are clear about the points we have to discuss or we have to take in our interactions, whether we are clear about these feelings, absoluteness of these feelings, means something definite we know about these feelings, or we are random Means we want, we naturally desire respect, but do we care about respect, or we are just visualizing respect as touching feet or shaking hands or something, means in form of expression. So what's my own competence, what's my own ability that we are exploring? So let us explore this.
Yes, we have Nachiketa Kamari ji.
Am I audible, madam?
Ji sir.
Good evening, Upasana ji, and namaskar to others. Actually, let me explain the way I saw the entire video. In the first part, if we see the mother requesting her son to take breakfast, and for some reasons the boy is not taking, there is a little amount of quarrel, and sees he is going out of the home. So if you see all interactions in the first part of the video, is the boy, though the boy is in a different place at a different time, but the quarrel, but his mind is still in the home. That is that he is not in the time domain, neither in now, not in here. So his entire action is being guided by a past recordings or some past incidents. But if we look at the second part of the video, because the kind of joy, the kind of positivity that has been there, so each actors in the second part of the video, you will find them to be at the same space here and now. That is probably the most important message the cinematographer wants to tell, that whatever actions we will be doing, and if we are not at the present, at that particular space, and still our mind will be somewhere, either guided by a past incident, then definitely we are not in harmony. We are in disharmony with ourselves, with our family, with the entire nature. And so definitely our actions will not be guided by right understanding, and definitely the consequences will be disastrous. But in the second part, if you will see, all of them are in the right space at the right time, here and now. So they are in harmony, and that's why the actions are guided by right understanding, and the whole, the conclusions also, you will see everything is being done in a positive way. So that is what, according to me, I have observed from the videos. Thank you, madam.
So a good point that is that's raised by you, that is this past baggage, if one is carrying, that disturbs the relationship, and if we are free from that baggage, there may be this good understanding while fulfilling the relationship. But it is important to see that we are able to see in bad relationship or in bad sequences that these past baggages are creating trouble. But in positive sequences, let's explore whether we are misguided through these past baggages which we are referring here, conditionings, or here we are deciding at my own. Means when the situations are seemingly better, when when it is apparent to see the happiness spreading, whether we are able to see that this is because of my own understanding, or this is also under influence in this video, in this documentary. What you say?
Yes, we have Rinal Prasad ji.
Yes, good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon to madam also. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yes. So everything is actually based on, that means whatever video it is being recorded or it is being shown, it is motivated by, the first one is basically it is motivated by the preconditioning, and that preconditioning has led it to this anger and this disharmony in the entire situation. And it is also motivated by some sensation also. So as per my view is concerned, so in the second part, there is a right evaluation in every stage, and accordingly we have achieved our harmonious state in every relationship. So this is my actually the sum up of the entire things within very few minutes.
Yes, appreciable, sir. So let me ask with every participant, what is naturally acceptable to me? Is it reaction or is it response in relationship? What is naturally acceptable? Let me get answers from your side in chat box. What is naturally acceptable? So we are getting answers in form of, we all are wanting for or desiring for a response. It is naturally acceptable. So this response, this is outcome of we explored with various instances that this is actually outcome of my own feeling at my own right. And whenever I am conditioned or I am governed or regulated from outside, that reflects in form of reaction. And that may be positive, that may be negative. But reaction, that is temporary, that is that may not be continued forever. And this response which we need in each and every relationship, this response is expected as well as may be expressed in each and every moment or in each and every incidence of life, provided we work on our own understanding as well as our own feeling. So when we work or when we start understanding the absolute feelings and ensure these feelings within, we can see that there are certain feelings in relationship which are desirable, like trust, that is to be assured that each and everyone that is wanting or desiring or natural acceptance of each and everyone is for happiness. And this is definite and unconditional. As and when I'm able to see this, I'm able to see other self also with the same natural acceptance. And in that situation, we become complementary. The competence-wise, whosoever is in the relationship among two or more, whosoever is more competent in understanding as well as in understanding various feelings in its absoluteness, he or she will be responsible to impart, to cooperate or collaborate with others, to be complementary with other, to understand as well as to ensure the feeling in relationship. So this is actually a response we desire. This way we become self-organized, as in when we are able to see the self, the natural acceptance of self, the activities of self, the mechanism of self, how the self is acting, how the self is taking decision, how the self is being influenced, in what percentage, in what percentage sensation is influencing the self, and how much one is able to decide on the basis of natural acceptance. So as much as I will be able to see these various sources and I'll be able to regulate my own source of imagination, I'll be able to respond in various actions or in various decision makings of life. So this way it is desirable for every one of us to see our own interactions, taking the interactions and find out the percentage time you are responding and the percentage time you are reacting. And also, what is the effort required to progress from reaction to response? So this way we are gradually improving within qualitative improvement we are efforting for. So to develop the right understanding, at least about relationship, we are required to understand in detail, and that will be part of UHV2 course, and as I wish to communicate here, as well as to be aware about your imagination in depth, that is to develop the right feelings within. This is also we'll explore in depth in second year in detail. And how we can repair the damage from past reactions, which we already applied in various interactions that you know, we will be able to look into further when we'll be able to see various sources influencing our decision makings like preconditioning, sensation, as well as one natural innate faculty which is there within, which we are calling here on the basis of self-verification as natural acceptance, feeling of natural acceptance. So we had seen this documentary, we watched this documentary, we discussed various instances, and we concluded like a variety of sources are there and percentage is varying. And now we are going to notice the percentage of influencing factor in our day-to-day interaction so that we may put some effort towards our own qualitative improvement. So with this, I wish to conclude today's session. For responding, everyone.
Thank you, Didi. It is 3:30. So thank you, everyone, for sharing. We will like to see you again in the practice sessions at 4 in your respective groups. Namaste, everyone. Namaste, Didi.
Namaste,
everyone.
Everybody, namaste. Thank you.